was that?
Wait, I know you.
Good, you're back. Well, what did Mallory have to say? Is the amulet authentic? The Elder Council? Oh, now that explains quite a bit. Motier, you naughty, naughty boy. Hiring the Dark Brotherhood to help you rise beyond your station. Delicious. Was Mallory willing to buy the amulet? Splendid. Then we're ready to begin. Or, more specifically, you're ready to begin. After all, you're the one the Night Mother spoke to. Now then, I hope you have something nice to wear, because you're going to a wedding. Well, more like the public reception. It should be a lovely affair. You'll mingle with the guests, eat some cake, stab the bride. Oh, yes. You've got to kill the bride. At her wedding. And they say romance is dead. Your target's name is Vittoria Vici. She oversees the East Empire Company's business holdings in Solitude. The wedding is being held in that city, at the Temple of the Divines. Her death will cause an uproar, which is exactly what we want. Vici is likely to address her guests frequently, as is the wedding custom. Kill her when she does that, and I promise you a significant bonus. Now go, and give the City of Solitude a celebration they're not likely to forget. This is a public kill. How you do it is entirely up to you. Arrow to the throat, knife in the belly. Your choice, so long as it's loud and messy. Because of the current political climate, people are going to assume the murder is related to the bad blood between the Legion and Stormcloaks. In any event, when Vici dies, it's going to be complete pandemonium. Best have your escape route planned out in advance. An excellent question. Vittoria Vici is the first cousin to our dear Emperor, Titus Mede II. Vici has obvious imperial connections. Her husband has ties to the Stormcloaks. Their union is a step toward reconciliation. So if there's a murder at the wedding, not only will it stall the peace process, it will send shockwaves throughout the entire Empire. The Emperor's hand will be forced. He'll have to travel to Skyrim to deal with the aftermath. And he'll find the Dark Brotherhood waiting. He had a trip to Skyrim planned for months, and cancelled at the last minute, much to his cousin's dismay. Seems the Emperor realized his presence would necessitate a more direct role in the ongoing hostilities, a role he was obviously unwilling to take. All that will change with his cousin's murder. Everyone will think it was motivated by the conflict between the Imperial Legion and Stormcloaks. And the Emperor will be forced to come clean up the mess. Off to Solitude with you. Time to give the Emperor some real motivation to visit Skyrim.
If you want rumors, you should talk to Corpulus.
The winking skeever's got warm beds and cold mead. You look like you could use both.
I wish only to graduate and enroll with the Legion. My drums will lead our troops to victory.
Good morning.
Dean Inga says a bard can never have enough practice. So, would you like a tune?
If you need potions, head over to Angeline's Aromatics.
Disrespect the law and you disrespect me.
Typical Imperial rot. You speak of Skyrim like you know the land. Know its people. You're from Cyrodiil. You know nothing about us.
I'm so glad Vittoria and Asgir chose a public reception. That way the entire city can share in their holy bond.
Stormcloaks refused to listen to Imperial authority. Such seditious behavior. Why, it's treason!
When the elves marched into your beloved Cyrodiil, and everyone took up arms against them, wasn't that treason? Against the Dominion, huh?
Is that an amulet of Mara? I'm surprised.
Conquerors! We had to fight them to preserve our own way of life.
My point exactly.
La 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 la
Friends and neighbors. Are you all enjoying yourselves? Please, eat, drink, and make merry on this most happy of days. These days, it seems there is dread everywhere, whether it be war or dragon. But I beg you.
Vittoria! No!
Did you hear something?
The bride has been murdered! Somebody help!
Chaos erupted. I'll try and hold them off as best I can. You get back to the sanctuary.
The news is everywhere. Vittoria Vici, the Emperor's cousin, butchered at her own wedding. Well done. Let's see His Eminence try to ignore this. With Vici's murder, you've started us down a path the Dark Brotherhood hasn't traveled in centuries. The assassination of an emperor. And now your reward. A unique spell to summon a legend of the Dark Brotherhood. His soul serves us now in death, as his body once did in life. Ah, and of course, a bonus for killing Vici while she addressed her guests as instructed. Gold. Simple and pure. Spend it as you will. Now then, time to proceed to the next stage of the plan. Go and speak with Gabriella. She's been helping me arrange your next contract. As I said, go speak with Gabriella. She's been assisting me with your next contract. This Emperor business? Well, it does involve everyone. As I said, go speak with Gabriella. She's been assisting me with your next contract.
It's been quite a boon, looking like a child. No one ever suspects a thing.
Nobody ever expects a fireball from the darkened corner.
Dear brother, I've been waiting back for you. Your next contract awaits, as I'm sure
I'm so
Astrid
won't
indicated.
Be forgetting that wedding anytime soon,
With the Emperor's arrival in Skyrim now a certainty, his security service, the Penitus Oculatus, will need to begin its preparations immediately. Security is being handled by a Commander Maro. Astrid and I have devised a plan to break the man, and in doing so, cripple the Emperor's protection. You are to slay the Commander's son, Gaius Maro, and once he is dead, plant false evidence on his body, implicating him in a plot to kill the Emperor. He is set to leave the Penitus Oculatus outpost at Dragonbridge, and inspect the security of each city in Skyrim. Go there now. Observe Gaius Maro's departure and follow him. Waylay him in one of the cities and send his soul to Sithis. Once he's dead, plant the incriminating letter on his body and let fate take care of the rest. Oh, and one final thing. To earn your bonus, do not kill Gaius Maro in Dragonbridge or on the road. Kill him in one of the other major cities he'll be visiting. There, the body will be discovered quickly, as will the letter implicating Gaius Maro in the plot to assassinate the Emperor. Do that, and Astrid has authorized me to grant you a rather unique bonus. It is a special token to be given to Olava the Feeble in Whiterun. Olava is an old and dear friend, and a powerful seer. The token entitles you to a reading of your future. It's an opportunity one should not pass up. Killing Commander Maro would do no good. Someone would merely replace him. No, we need him to remain in charge, but distracted, weakened. Implicate and kill his son Gaius, and the Commander will be grief-stricken and humiliated, his family name ruined. The security plan will then fail. Best yet, the Emperor will be lulled into a false sense of security, thinking an assassination plot had already been discovered and foiled. No, so your best plan is to follow him after he leaves Dragonbridge. However, there is one other option. We know there's an actual written travel schedule, somewhere in the Penitus Oculatus outpost. Securing that would, obviously, be most beneficial. It's a small town, with one rather unique feature. It houses Skyrim's only Penitus Oculatus outpost. It was established by Commander Maro when he first arrived in Skyrim several months ago, when he began preparing for the Emperor's initial visit. Walk in Gaius Maro's shadow and deliver to him the judgment of Sithis.
remember. Need something?
Thank you. In my time, the Blades protected the Emperor. It would seem these penitus oculatus will prove equally incompetent. Stalking your prey, planting false evidence, destroying an innocent man's reputation. Truly, a contract worthy of the listener.
Stay alert. When you get to the cities, make your observations and move on.
I understand. But you're being paranoid. I'm inspecting security, not charging off into battle. There's not a lot that can go wrong.
Son, when the Emperor's safety is concerned, anything could go wrong. Off with you now, and good travels.
I grow restless.
Farewell, father.
As does my blade.
Well, this is it then. Look after yourself, Gaius. You're doing your duty, and I'm proud of you, but you better come back to me. You hear?
Oh, Fida. I may travel alone, but you know I carry you always in my heart.
From my youth.
I'll see you soon.
And the glistening crimson on fields of white.
Trust me, we have nothing to say to one another.
The cousin of the Emperor was murdered, in Solitude, at her own damn wedding. Not a chance we would have let that happen here.
There is murder in the air. I can taste it.
Keep back, citizen. I have important business I must attend to. I'm sorry, but I really don't have time for this. Move along.
The Dread Father works through me.
If you want rumors, you should talk to Corpulus.
Emperor's cousin killed. Right here. Solitude. I feel nothing but shame.
No funny business unless you want a few inches of steel in your belly. Try to hide it all you want.
I have to wonder, what does the Dragonborn do once he's summoned by...
I've had enough of you!
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on White...
He'd be insane.
What was that?
No! That's your best fight! It's nothing!
I'm going to... You are trying my patience, citizen. Back away. Now.
That's not what my scouts report, sir. Every day, more join his cause. Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not a cause. It's a rebellion.
Call it whatever you
want. I fear the night.
The man's going to try to take
white. Because the werewolves and vampires don't.
Jarl Balgruuf.
Balgruuf refuses the Legion's right to garrison troops in his city. On the other hand, he also refuses to acknowledge Ulfric's
right. What is it, Argonian? Disrespect the law, you disrespect me.
Well, if he wants to stand outside the protection of the Empire, fine. Let Ulfric pillage his city.
General.
You are trying my patience, citizen.
Get bits and pieces. Watch the skies, traveler.
You can't force a Nord to accept help he hasn't asked for.
If Ulfric's making a move for Whiterun, then we need to be there to stop it. Draft another letter with the usual platitudes, but this time share some of your intelligence regarding Ulfric. Plans. Embellish if you have to. We'll let it seem like it's his idea.
Yes, sir.
You Nords and your bloody sense of honor.
Sir.
Can't wait to kill another of Ulfric's boys. Think you've got the metal, huh? Honestly, the Legion can use all the able bodies it can muster. We have our hands full. A dead king, a rebellion, and now dragons? Skyrim's a mess. If you're serious, you're in the right place. Our headquarters is in Castle Dower. Here you'll... But talk to Legate Rikka. She handles the local recruiting. You mean Ulfric's so-called Stormcloak Rebellion? The Nord Kings, oh. Sadly, the Empire's stretched a little thin these days, and we've gotten very few. But rest assured, citizen, we'll put an end to this uprising, and things will get back to normal soon enough. I'll take my leave then.
You are trying my patience, citizen. Back away. Now.
What are you doing that for?
for a dragon to attack Kynesgrove. Why? Why there? Is no place safe?
Pine Moon Cave is down to the southwest. What is it?
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
He'd be insane to try. He doesn't have the men.
That's not what my
scouts report,
sir.
You can set off that junk at bits and pieces. If it's arms or armor you need, see Berend in Castle Dower. Bloody good blacksmith, that one.